All right, everybody, this video of the week is about solving logarithmic and exponential equations. I've gotten a lot of questions about these in the last couple of days, so I figured I'd send this out as some last minute help. Okay, if you see an equation like this, and it has a couple of logarithms in it, they have the same base, so you can actually combine them using the rules from the previous video. That was video of the week number 12. We can use what we called the quotient rule to combine these two logarithms that are being subtracted. Okay, now we have this thing down to a single logarithm. We need to get these x's out of the logarithm so that we can solve for x. All right, in video of the week number 11, I wrote down these two forms for our exponential and logarithmic equations, and I explained that these are actually exactly the same equation, just written in two different ways. I believe I also explained in the previous video that a log without a base on it is actually technically a log base 10. Okay, the reason I wrote this over here is because what we want to do is we want to switch the form of this equation from a logarithmic equation to an exponential equation. There's more than one way to think about doing this, but maybe the simplest way is to see that the base of this is 10, the other side of the equation is a 2, and that's going to become the power in our exponential equation. And whatever is inside the logarithm right here, that goes on the other side of the equation by itself. So we're just switching from a logarithmic equation to an exponential equation by moving the terms around. Now, 10 squared is just 100. And the question is, how do we solve for x at this point? Well, we multiply both sides of the equation by x plus 3. I'm going to give us just a little bit of space here. I'm going to distribute the 100. I'm going to subtract 100x from both sides. And I'm going to divide both sides of the equation by negative 99. And that is going to be our solution for x. Okay, feel free to pause that if you'd like. I'm going to move on to the next problem here. Here again, we're in the situation where we have two logarithms. They have the same base, so we can combine them. We combine two logarithms that are added together by multiplying what's inside of them. If you'd like, you can do this now or you could do this step later, but at some point in this problem, you're going to distribute this x through these parentheses. And at some point in this problem, we're going to switch from a logarithmic equation to an exponential equation. So our base is 2, the other side of the equation becomes the power, and whatever's inside of the logarithm becomes the other side of the equation in our exponential form of our equation. 2 to the 4th is 16. Now what do we have here? Well, this is actually a quadratic equation. One of the first rules for quadratic equations is generally when you solve them, you want to get everything on one side of the equation in a 0 on the other side of the equation. Now, if we're lucky, we can factor this quadratic to save ourselves some time. If we're not lucky, we might have to use the quadratic formula. Having two factors multiplied by one another set equal to 0, we can split this problem up into two pieces. We can say x plus 8 equals 0 and x minus 2 equals 0 separately. That's going to give us two different answers. We have x equals negative 8 as our first possible solution, and we have x equals 2 as our second possible solution. Now, I say possible solution because we should check. Sometimes we get results here that aren't actual solutions of a logarithmic equation. So okay, x equals 2 we'll check first. If you plug in x equals 2 to the original equation, you have log base 2 of 8 plus log base 2 of 2 equals 4. Log base 2 of 8 is 3, log base 2 of 2 is 1, and yes, those should add up to 4. If you're struggling with why this is 3 and why this is 2, please go back to, I believe, video of the week number 11 for an explanation. So we checked our result, x equals 2, and it checks out just fine. But if we check our x equals negative 8 result, we're going to get log base 2 of negative 2 and log base 2 of negative 8, somehow adding up to 4. Well, the problem is you can't actually plug negative numbers into logarithms at all. So this solution does not work. We're going to cross that one out, and the only solution we come up with for this equation is x equals 2. Okay, I want to make a bit of a side note about this step right here. I'm going to pull that out down here and take another look at it. There's a technique for going from this step to this step that I actually prefer because it's a little bit more algebraic. What I did in the previous example is I just referenced the two equations, the logarithmic equation and the equivalent exponential equation, and said that you could go back and forth between the two, just switching the numbers around appropriately. But sometimes I forget how to do that. So maybe a more algebraic approach to get the same answer is to do something to both sides of the equation. The way that I always think of solving this equation is actually putting each side of the previous equation into the power of 2. We're allowed to do this because we're doing the same thing to both sides of the equation. And from your studies of exponential equations and logarithms, you might remember that if the logarithm and the exponential equation have the same base, and they're actually right next to each other in this equation, in a sense they cancel each other out. Technically, these two are inverses. What we're left with then is just the x squared plus 6x. And on the right side of the equation, we still have the 2 to the 4th. You'll notice that this is the exact same thing that we ended up getting the other technique. So you can use whichever technique you like. I just tend to remember this one. I'm putting either side of an equation in the power of some number. It's called exponentiating, which is also a pretty fun word. And the reason that I chose 2 as the number to exponentiate was because it was the base of the logarithm. Therefore, these two canceled out, and we're left with the equation that we want. Okay, end of side note, let's take a look at another example here. To me, this is a really big reason why we study logarithms in the first place, because we spend a lot of time solving for x in this class, but we never really talk about what happens if the x is up in an exponent of a problem. Well, it might not come as a surprise in this section that what we're going to do is we're going to take this exponential equation and we're going to switch it into a logarithmic equation. If we move the numbers around appropriately, let's see, the base of the exponential equation becomes the base of the logarithm. The other side of the exponential equation goes inside of the logarithm, and the power in the exponential equation ends up out by itself. So that's our answer, actually. X is the log base 3 of 5. If you're going to enter that into a calculator, you can enter log of 5 over log of 3. That's your change of base formula, and that'll give you some decimal. If you're asked for an exact answer, this answer is perfectly fine, and this answer is perfectly fine as well. Okay, another side note here. There's a more algebraic way to do this. Now, if you want to isolate X by doing something to the left side and the right side of the equation, what we can do is we can take the log base 3 of either side of the equation. And in your studies of logarithms and exponential equations, you might remember if the base of your logarithm and the base of your exponential equation are the same and they're right next to each other, they actually cancel out. They're inverses of each other. What that leaves is just the x on the left side, and you get log base 3 of 5 on the right side, and that's the exact answer we got previously. So again, that's a little more algebraic way to do it. You can do it however you'd like, of course. I just wanted to throw that out there. Okay, let's look at another example. You might occasionally come across an equation that looks something like this. You have two different bases, and they're raised to two different powers. I'm going to copy down 2 to the 3x, and I'm going to rewrite 4 as 2 squared. So I've just replaced 4 with 2 squared, which is totally allowed, and that's still raised to the x plus 2 power. Now remember our properties of exponents that say if you have an exponent on another exponent, you can actually multiply those exponents, and in this case that would involve distributing. So you can write this right side as 2 to the 2x plus 4 power, because we're distributing that 2 exponent to the x plus 2. Now that we have two sides of the equation with the exact same base and two different exponents, we know that those two different exponents must equal each other. Now this is an equation that's easy to solve. We can just subtract 2x from both sides. 3x minus 2x is just x equals 4. And as always, it would be smart to check your answer, plug it in up here, and make sure it works out. Okay, I have one more example for us, and then we will be finished. I have 2 e to the 3x plus 1 power equals 100. The first thing we want to make sure we do is we get this base sort of on the side of the equation by itself. So I'm going to divide both sides of this equation by 2. Now we can take this exponential equation and we can convert it to a logarithmic equation. That logarithmic equation is going to have a base of e. 50 is going to go inside the logarithm, and the power 3x plus 1 is going to end up over here by itself. Of course, we usually don't write log base e, we usually write natural log. Now solving for x is just a little bit of algebra. We can subtract 1 from both sides. Now to get x by itself, we're going to divide both sides of the equation by 3. And if you enter this into your calculator, that will be your answer for x. I've given you the exact answer. If you type it into your calculator, you'll get a decimal, which will be an approximation. Okay, I hope that helps you with a few of the homework problems. Let me know if you have any more questions, and good luck on the quiz.